Welcome to a lesson on Jefferson's method of apportionment. After Washington vetoed Hamilton's method, Thomas Jefferson proposed a new method called Jefferson's method. It was used in Congress from 1791 through 1842. The method does tend to favor large states, and Jefferson happened to live in Virginia, the largest state at the time. Jefferson's method differs from Hamilton's method on how to resolve the situation when the lower quota or initial quota is less than the actual seats available. So the first three steps of Jefferson's method is the same as Hamilton's method. Step one, determine how many people each representative should represent. We do this by dividing the total population of all the states by the total number of representatives. This answer is called the standard divisor, or just a divisor. Step two, we divide each state's population by the divisor to determine how many representatives it should have. We record this answer to several decimal places, and this answer is called the quota. Step three, we cut off the decimal part of all the quotas. These values are the lower quotas, or initial apportionment. We add these whole numbers. This answer will always be less than or equal to the total number of representatives. If it's equal to the total number of representatives, we would be done. But if it's not, then we go to step four. Step four says, if the total from step three is less than the total number of representatives, we actually reduce the divisor and recalculate the quota and initial allocation. So if we have leftover representatives, we actually modify the divisor rather than using the decimal parts of the quotas as we do when using Hamilton's rule. So if we have leftover representatives, we actually change a divisor. Remember, in Hamilton's rule, we rely on the decimal parts of the quota. So for Jefferson's method, we reduce the divisor and recalculate the quota and allocation. We continue doing this until the total from step three is equal to the total number of representatives. The divisor we end up using is called the modified divisor or adjusted divisor. So let's look at an example. A college offers tutoring in math, English, chemistry, and biology. The number of students enrolled in each subject is listed below. If the college can only afford to hire 21 tutors, determine how many tutors should be assigned to each subject using Jefferson's method. So the first step is to find the total enrollment, which we see here is 890. And since we have 21 tutors to allocate, we find the standard divisor by taking 890 and dividing by 21. So the standard divisor is approximately 42.3810. And now to find the quota for each subject, we take the enrollment for each subject and divide by our standard divisor. Let's go and show a couple of these. So to find the quota for math, we would have 360 divided by 42.3810. To three decimal places, the quota would be approximately 8.494. The quota for English would be 315 divided by 42.3810, which would be approximately 7.433. We would do the same for chemistry and biology. So here we see the quotas for the four disciplines. And now to find the initial apportionment or initial allocation, remember we dropped the decimal part of the quota. So math gets 8, English gets 7, chemistry gets 3, and biology gets 1. But notice how using the initial apportionment, notice how the total is 19, and we have a total of 21 tutors. So now we're going to modify the standard divisor, or reduce the standard divisor, recalculate these quotas until we find an initial apportionment here that does sum to 21. So let's go ahead and reduce this to, let's say, 42, and then recalculate these quotas. So if we use a modified divisor of 42, now we're going to take the enrollment of each subject and divide by 42. And let's go ahead and show a couple of these. So again, for math, with the modified divisor, we'd have 360 divided by 42, which is approximately 8.571. For English, we'd have 315 divided by 42, which is equal to 7.5. So I think you get the idea, but notice how if we cut off the decimal parts of the quota, notice how we have 8, 7, 3, 1, but still notice how the total here is 19, not 21. So now we need to reduce the divisor again. Let's go ahead and try 40 and see what happens. We can see from the completed table, with a modified divisor of 40, everything works out perfectly. But again, let's go ahead and show some of the division to find these quotas. This time, let's show the quota for chemistry, which would be 135 divided by 40, which is exactly 3.375. And of course, for biology, 80 divided by 40 would be 2. So using these quotas and ignoring the decimals, we have an allocation of 9,732, which does give us a sum of 21 tutors. Therefore, we now have the final allocation using Jefferson's method. And again, our final modified divisor was 40. Let's take a look at a second example. A legislature in a state has 57 seats. Apportion these seats to 6 counties below using Jefferson's method. First step, we find the total population of all the states, which is given here, 1,229,000. We have 57 states to apportion, so the standard divisor is going to be the total population divided by 57, which is given here to 3 decimal places. And now to find the quota for each county, we'll take the population of the county and divide by our standard divisor, which again has already been done here, but let's go ahead and check the first two. So we have 283,000 divided by 21,651.404, which would give us approximately 13.071, which we see here. And then for grant, we would have 153,000 divided by 21,651.404, which gives a quota of approximately 7.067, and so on. So now for the initial apportionment, we ignore the decimal part of the quota, so we have 13, 7, 4, 15, 10, and 5. Notice here the total is 54, but we have 57 seats to apportion. So for the next step, we reduce the standard divisor, recalculate the quota, and repeat the process. We repeat the process until this allocation here sums to the total seats, which would be 57. So we need to reduce this. You might be asking how far to reduce it, and that's the challenge of Jefferson's method. Let's reduce the divisor to 20,000, and again recalculate the quotas, which I've already done. Again, we take each state population, divide by 20,000 to get these quotas here. And now for the allocation, we remove the decimal part, so we have 14, 7, 5, 17, 11, and 5. Notice here we reduced the divisor too much because now the allocation is for 59 seats and we only have 57. So now we need to increase the divisor, and the challenge is how much do we increase the divisor? Let's say we increase the divisor to 20,200. Recalculate the quotas. Remove the decimal part for our allocation. So with a divisor of 20,200, we have an allocation of 14, 7, 5, 17, 11, and 5. Again, notice how we have too many seats. This is 59, and we only have 57, which means we now increase the divisor again. So let's try 20,300. Using the divisor of 20,300, we would have these quotas. Removing the decimal part, we'd have 13, 7, 5, 17, 10, and 5, which does give us a sum of 57 seats. So we're finally done, and this would be the final allocation using Jefferson's rule. So as you can see, the challenge on Jefferson's rule is coming up with the correct divisor so that once we calculate the new quotas and remove the decimal part, the allocation sums to the number of seats available. I hope you found this explanation helpful.